Wow, you finally made it to the spot. That was a rough ride up the mountain. A lot of potholes and rocks, especially for this vehicle. It's not designed for off-road trips, but we made it up here in one piece. It took us a while to get up here, but we finally made it. Because looks like it's gonna rain. It's very cloudy right now. Right now we're at the there should be a lake right here. I believe there's a dam around here somewhere where they would shut off the dam in a certain month of the year, and the water level would rise all the way up to this rock here. So this whole thing here, this whole space here, would just become a lake. I'm sure it's gonna start raining pretty soon, so we will need to set up the tarp. Okay, well, let's go ahead and set up the tarp, and I'll see you guys in a bit.
Well, we made it just on time. The rain is pouring down as we finish setting up the tarp. Right on time. It's not raining too hard right now, but I have a feeling it's gonna get pretty heavy pretty soon. So I'm glad we're all set up with the tarp and prepare for the rain tonight. I'm just gonna take a few more gear for the car. We've got a chair, a table, and get our food ready for dinner. It's getting dark right now pretty fast, so we gotta get moving. But this rain is actually pretty nice. And we're the only one here. Very peaceful and quiet. That's how I like it. As you can see through the distance, beautiful place.
It's getting dark pretty fast now, so I'm just gonna set up our sleeping space, and then we're gonna prepare dinner. There's no fire tonight, guys. It's getting dark too fast, and I have no time to go collect wood for that. So we're just gonna set this up quickly. The rain is starting to pick up pretty fast, and it's gonna make our dinner, and then we'll just relax for a bit. Then we're gonna call it a night. So now we'll be having, we got some Shanghai bok choy here. It's gonna be a quick instant noodle. What is this? Some kind of kimchi noodles. I'm just gonna mix, cook that with the bok choy. And we have, what else? That's Sarang's food. Sarang? Back, thanks, back. Good girl. Okay. And then I got a couple eggs as well to that. The rain has picked up pretty hard, so I'm trying to start cooking dinner. And then it's also getting really dark now too. Let's prepare Sarang's food first, and then I'll get mine ready. Sarang, back. Back. Good girl. Stay. I got your food here, son. No. Frank, back.
saves the other half for tomorrow morning. Okay. So tonight we're having Earl Grey IPA to go with our dinner tonight. It's from Salt Spring Brewing Company. I think this is a local one. Yeah. Alright guys, dinner's done. Oh. And the rain just won't stop. Everybody's getting heavier and heavier. Oh, starting to pool here. A lot of water here. We got a lot of rain right now, guys. I'm gonna get some tea going, and then we're just gonna relax for a bit outside, and then we'll head inside the car. And I don't know if there's any reception here or not, but we'll find out later. If there is, we'll watch a movie inside. All right, let's get this tea going, and I have a story I want to tell you guys. So tonight's tea, we got Earl Grey black tea. So a couple days ago, we're at my friend's house having dinner, and we left around 9 p.m. And after we're leaving, and we went outside, and I turned it back for like 5 seconds, and all I saw was the rain, just zoomed past me into the dark. I didn't know what was happening. And then I ran to her, and I realized what just happened. As soon as I ran to her, she ran back to me. She was crawling on the grass, rubbing her face on the grass. She was coughing, and she her eyes were closed. And I realized right away that she got the skunk got her right in the face. Full blast right in the face. I panicked. I didn't know what to do. I didn't know what to do. I mean, it was my first time dealing with a skunk situation. And I didn't know what to do. So the first thing that came through my head was, all right, I gotta get her washed off. So I carry her up back into my parents' house, into the bathroom, and into the bathtub, and for 15 minutes I was showering her, for 15 minutes washing her face, and I was rubbing her face, and I can feel the oil, I guess it's just the skunk spray, but it felt very oily, and I can feel all the oil that's coming off. I was washing for 15 minutes. Yeah, I didn't know what's gonna happen. Like, I didn't know if she needed medical attention or anything like that. So I asked my family to look for a vet. And I told them to call the vet, see what we need to do. So they call. And luckily, it wasn't anything serious. So they said that I just gotta wash her off and clean her and all this stuff. Well, so I was washing over 15 minutes, and she was a couple of times she was shaking the water off and got all the water and all the skunk smell all over my body, my face, my hands, everywhere. But I sat there for 15 minutes washing her face off, washing her body, just trying to rub off as much as I could off her. And for the whole time, her eyes were closed. And after 15 minutes, she started to open her eyes again. So once I saw that, I felt like a relief. So it wasn't fun. But now my whole car, the house and everything, now like skunk right now. Even her surrounding face right now, once you get close up to her face, you can smell a very strong skunk smell. But yeah, I'm glad that ended well, and she's okay now. But in the moment, I was very scared. Like, I didn't know what to do. Like, I didn't know what was gonna happen to her. but I'm glad it wasn't too serious. So lesson learned there. Next time it happened, hopefully it doesn't happen again, but if it does happen, we know what to how to deal with it. So yeah. Oh, so that's the story, how Saran got skunked right in the face. Alright guys, I'm just gonna enjoy this cup of tea. Just sit here, relax with Saran for a bit. Enjoy the rain. A lot of rain right now. It's nice and peaceful, just us here tonight. So yeah, I'll see you guys in a bit once we're inside the car.
Nobody else possesses that level of confidence. Go the wrong way, end up in the wrong place, call the wrong people the wrong name, and be like, I'm right, give me a holiday. Because the other country's there, and you have to prove to your country that you're loyal. That's why you sing the song.
Alright guys, we're just gonna wrap up here. It's getting pretty late. The rain's starting to die down a bit. It's starting to become a lot lighter now. Earlier it was raining pretty hard and it was really loud. And Saran got really scared and she was having a hard time sleeping. So I wrap her in her blanket. So I basically wrap her in her blanket and wrap her head so that it helps with her sleep. Right now she is, I think she's nice and relaxed right now. I think she's sleeping. But earlier the rain was so loud that she got a bit scared and she couldn't sleep. So I wrap her up and this helps a lot. Alright, that's it for tonight guys. I'll see you guys tomorrow morning. Good night. Morning. Looks like the rain has stopped, but everything is all soaking wet outside. Not sure how bad it is, but we'll see in a bit. Last night, we had a good sleep last night, even though it was raining pretty hard. Everything was all loud, making it harder to sleep, but it was good with the rain and everything. Looks like it's pretty foggy this morning as well. The fogs are coming in pretty hard. It's all white outside right now, yeah, because of all the fog. But everything is all beautiful right now as well. Alright, we're just gonna get up, clean up, have a cup of coffee, and get out of here and just enjoy the scenery a bit longer. And we'll get out of here. Alright, I'll see you guys in a bit.
All right, guys, we're all packed up, cleaned up, and ready to get out of here. It's gonna be a rough ride down the mountain, but should be fine. So we're just gonna take it easy. Hopefully it doesn't kill the car. Yeah, the mist looks like it's moving in pretty hard, and I don't know how foggy it's gonna be down the mountain. So we're just gonna take it nice and slow down. Alright guys, thanks for watching. That's it for this trip today, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Take care now. Bye.